and Kyle. Welcome to their wedding ceremony this evening at Jacaranda. In this place, we take ourselves out of the usual routines of daily living to witness a unique moment in the lives of the bride and the groom. Today, they join their lives in the union of marriage. To all of their guests, they are happy to share this moment with you. They have known most of you for several years. You watched them grow up, you went to school with them, or you worked with them. Because you are the ones who have supported them and know them so well, it is only fitting that you are the ones to share this once in a lifetime moment with them. Kyle and Paula are excited to have their parents in the front row, close to them for the ceremony. Paula thanks her parents for always giving her nothing less in the world and for loving her with their whole hearts. Kyle thanks his parents for all the love and support they gave him over the years. As Kyle and Paula prepared for this ceremony, they reflected on what it is that they love about each other. That was easy for them. Kyle, Paula loves that you blend in so well with her family. She loves that you are fantastic with children and how much you love your dog, Allie. She loves that you do the cooking and will watch Star Wars with her for days on end. She sees in you a funny, kind, and sweet man. She loves that you think she is funny and that you will always find a way to compliment her. Most importantly, you are so close that even when she's at her worst, you have never made her feel like you want anything but to be closer to her. Paula, Kyle loves that you always think about your relationship and put it first in your decisions and actions. He loves your brain, your smile, and your beauty. He loves that you can be really silly and that you can always eat his cooking. He just really loves you. The years will come and go. You won't take each other for granted. You will laugh a lot. You will be the best parents you can be. You will grow older and wiser together. It's a good story, and the ending is not in sight. Kyle and Paula have each selected a poem to be read by me for their wedding ceremony. I have decided to present these poems in a way that they could keep them forever. The first poem was picked by Paula. It's titled The Art of Marriage by Wilfred Marlin Peterson. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is being the right partner. It is discovering what marriage can be at its best. The second poem was selected by Kyle. It's called I Love You by Roy Croft. I love you, not only for who you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you, not only for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heart and passing over all the foolish, weak things that you can't help. Dimly seeing there and drawing out into the light all the beautiful belongings that no one else had looked quite so far enough to find. You have done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. Kyle and Paula, please step forward and take each other's hands so that you may see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love. These are the hands that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief temporarily comes your way. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will give you support and encouragement to chase down your dreams. These are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. We come now to the words that Paula and Kyle want to hear the most today. The words that take them across the threshold from being engaged to being married. A marriage is full of commitment. It is made in the deepest sense of love, with the desire that it will last forever. Kyle, take Paula to be your wedded wife. And do you, Paula, take Kyle to be your wedded husband?
I do.
Kyle and Paula, having heard that it is your intention to be married, I now ask you to declare your marriage vows. Paula, please repeat after me. I, Paula, take you, Kyle.
I, Paula, take you, Kyle.
To be my husband, I will share my life with yours,
build our dreams together,
support you through times of trouble,
and rejoice with you in times of happiness. All trials and triumphs of our lives together.
This commitment is made in love,
lived in hope,
and made new every day of our lives. Kyle, please repeat after me.
I, Kyle, take you, Paula,
to be my wife. I will share my life with yours.
Support you through times of trouble.
And rejoice with you in times of happiness.
I promise to give you
respect, love, loyalty, and laughs.
Through all trials and triumphs.
Of our lives together.
This commitment is made in love.
Lived in hope.
lived in hope,
and made new every day of our lives.
And made new every day of our lives.
Your wedding rings are the outward and visible sign of the inward and invisible bond which already united your two hearts in love. I asked Jeremy to give Paula's ring to Kyle. Kyle, place the ring on Paula's finger and repeat after me.
I give you this ring. Wear it with love and joy.
As this ring has no end.
My love is also forever.
Jeremy, now please give Kyle's ring to Paula. Paula, place the ring on Kyle's finger and repeat after me.
I give you this ring. Wear it with love and joy. As this ring has no end. My love is also forever.
May the wedding rings you exchange today remind you always that you are surrounded by enduring love. Paula and Kyle, I offer these good wishes to you on this special day. May your life together be blessed with prosperity and good health. May you always share open and honest communication between each other. May you respect each other's individual talents and gifts and give full support to each other's professional and personal pursuits. May you cherish the home and family you will create together. May all the years to come be filled with moments to celebrate and renew your love. May your love be a lifelong source of excitement, joy, affection, respect, and devotion for one another. Now, by the power vested in me, it is my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. I am pleased to present the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Kyle Green. Thank you.